Good afternoon, everybody. I just got back from a spin class and I wanted to sit down and film a video for you guys about my road to medical school, my road to MD-PhD. I want to kind of introduce myself again and where I'm at. My name's Lauren. I am in my second gap year out of college and I have been accepted to an MD-PhD dual degree program at Virginia Commonwealth University. And I kind of just want to talk about my journey here, how I got here, the things that I did that I think helped me get into medical school. The things that I think are most important to focus on in order to get into medical school are shadowing experience, volunteer experience, and academic ability. Academics is kind of one of those things that everyone knows has to be on point in order to get into medical school. And although grades aren't the most important thing, they are really important because medical schools are investing a lot of money into your education. And you're also investing a lot of money into your education. And the medical schools want to make sure that you are going to be successful when you get into school. So having a strong academic ability in college really shows schools that you have the ability to do well. One of the other really important things is shadowing experience. So schools want to see that you know what it's going to be like to be a doctor. They want to see that you took the time to spend time with doctors and to shadow them and to see what their life is like, and you still want to do medicine anyway because the life of a doctor is not always super glamorous, and most times it's actually pretty difficult. And they want to make sure that before you get into medical school and you invest all of this time going to school and going through your application process and dedicating yourself to medicine, they want to make sure that you know what you're getting into. And then the other most important thing is volunteer experience. Medical schools want to see that you're dedicated to serving your community and serving people who are going to come to you for medical help. So having a lot of volunteer experience is really a make or break point for medical school. So with those three things in mind, this is my journey to medicine. I knew I wanted to be a doctor since I was about 15 years old. So my mom is the director of a laboratory in a hospital in my hometown. And when my sister and I were kids, we used to visit her in the hospital all the time. And I felt like the doctors were the most interesting people that I ever saw when I was there. I was so interested in them running around the hospital and in their white coats with their scrubs and always wondering what they were doing. And I found them so interesting. And I mentioned it either to my mom or somebody who worked at the lab, I can't quite remember, but I mentioned it to somebody and they said, "Hey, I think you would be a good doctor if you wanted to do that." And ever since then, that's what I've been dedicated to. It took somebody telling me, "Hey, I think you could be a good doctor," for me to realize that that's what I wanted to do. Oh my gosh, my hair. There isn't a whole lot you can do as a high schooler to prepare yourself for medical school. The one thing you can do is getting shadowing and volunteer experiences. What I did was I asked my mom, who had some hookups in the hospital because she worked there, if she could track down a couple of physicians who would be willing to let me shadow them. One of the other things that I did was I volunteered in the emergency department in the VA hospital in my hometown. And that really showed me what a bunch of different medical professionals do. It showed me the role of a nurse and of radiology technicians and doctors and all of those different aspects of medicine, and being able to experience what a bunch of different medical professionals do and still deciding to be a doctor is something that medical schools are really going to want to see. Going to want to see that you know what a nurse does, a physician's assistant does, and you know what a nurse practitioner does, and you know what a doctor does, and you still want to be a doctor anyway. I also joined the National Ski Patrol when I was in high school. My dad taught me how to ski when I was about 2 or 3, and it was something that we shared a love for, and he was the National Ski Patroller when I was a kid. And he passed away when I was in high school. When he passed away, I wanted to join the National Ski Patrol as well, as a mixture of my love for skiing and medicine, and also something to bring me closer to him. So that was also a volunteer experience. That's a mostly volunteer program. And so I gained incredible experience from that. And it's something that really set me apart. Another thing that medical schools really want to see is that you have a diversity of experience from the other applicants who are applying the same cycle as you. Getting experiences and volunteer volunteer opportunities and shadowing experiences that are a little bit different than normal is a really important thing to have. Now, everybody is going to have shadowing experience. Everyone's going to have basic volunteer experience, but making sure that you are getting experiences that are going to set yourself apart from the other people who are applying is really important. Now, once I got to college, I majored in behavioral neuroscience. I also majored in philosophy and I got a minor in chemistry. And one of the things that made college really hard for me was I finished both of those degrees and my minor in 4 years. And boy, was I burnt out and tired at the end of college. And I'll explain a little bit more about that later. But one of the things that I found was helpful in college was majoring in a science. Now, you don't have to major in a science. You can major in whatever you want to in college. But in order to be a candidate for medical school, you have to take the basic sciences. So if I were to just major in philosophy, I would have also had to take general bio, general chemistry, ochem, biochem, genetics, cell molecule, all of those core science classes I would have had to take on top of my coursework for my arts degree. So majoring in a science is really a shortcut to taking all those classes anyway and not having to do extra work. One of the great things about my undergraduate institution is that we had a lot of opportunity to do research as undergrads. And so I took advantage of that opportunity really, really quickly. In my freshman year, actually, was when I emailed my PI, which stands for principal investigator, of the lab that I ended up working in and telling her that I was interested in her lab. So it was a neuroscience lab and we looked at Huntington's disease, and I was in that lab from end of freshman year to end of senior year. So that was about 3 years of work. And it was in that lab doing research that I realized that I loved research. My PI was also my academic advisor. And so I went to her one day and said, "Hey, I can't imagine giving up medicine because it's what I wanted to do since I was 14, 15. But now I've also found this love for research and I can't imagine giving up research either. I don't know which path to choose." And she said, "Well, they have these programs that allow you to get both an MD and a PhD, and it's for people who are wanting to be physician scientists. So maybe this is something you should look into." And I looked into it, and ever since then, I realized that that's what I wanted to do. So that's what I pursued. By doing so much research in undergrad, I realized that I really wanted to continue to do research throughout my career, and thus wanting to do the MD-PhD program. Now, I want to make the disclaimer that you don't have to have a PhD in order to do research as a physician. You can have an MD and do research almost just as easily. Take my boss, for example. She's an MD, but she does research, obviously, at St. Jude, and it's possible to do research without that graduate degree, but it is a lot easier because you have dedicated time to put into learning lab techniques and learning how to write grants and how to design a project and carry out a project and all of that stuff that you don't really get in medical school in an MD program. And if research is part of your plan, this was the best advice that I was given, was if you even have an inkling that research is part of your plan, then you should take the time to get the graduate degree as well. It really helps giving yourself that dedicated time to learn and to train, because once you're a physician, all of that has to come in your free time, which you really don't have. So spending the extra couple of years to get the PhD in an MD-PhD program is really, really beneficial. At least I felt so, especially since I know research is one of those things that I want to include in my career. Sorry if things look slightly different. Cole called me and I had to stop filming, so we're back on track. If you are in medical school, you're not in an MD-PhD program, and you realize that you want to do research, you can get a PhD after you're done with medical school. It's not like you have to do the dual degree program in order to get that degree. It just takes a little bit longer. The typical structure of MD-PhD programs is you do your first 2 years, your M1 and M2, which is your classroom-based stuff, and then you go into your grad years, which is between 3 and 5 years, depending on how long your project takes.
And then you go back into medical school to do your M3 and M4 years, which are your clinical years, and then you're done. So because I made college so difficult for myself, I was so burnt out and tired at the end that I couldn't imagine going into school again. And I wanted to take some time off before I went back to school. And because I wanted to do this MD-PhD program, I know that they really focus on meaningful research experience and a dedication to research. They want to make sure that if they're spending all this money putting you through school, that you're going to be successful. So they want to make sure that you're dedicated to doing research and that you have a lot of meaningful research experience and understand what it's going to be like to do research all day, every day for a couple of years. Day in and day out, tasks of research are really mundane and can get really boring. But the thing that I love about research is seeing all of your data and all of the fruits of your labor that you spent all this time doing coming together at the end and seeing whether or not your hypothesis was supported. That part of research is so cool for me, and it's the reason why I want to keep doing it. I knew that when I left school, I wanted to do research in my gap year. If you're going to do research before going into medical school, labs really won't hire you unless you can give the minimum of 2 years. And I'm going to go through all of this in another video, the benefits of being a non-traditional student, but most labs won't accept you as an employee unless you can dedicate at least 2 years, because within only 1 year, you're going to get trained, do a little bit of stuff, and then you're not going to be there anymore. And so it's a little bit of a waste of energy for you to only be there for a year. So I am in the middle of my second gap year now because I dedicated 2 years of research to St. Jude. And it was really important to me to do research that I felt was going to be pertinent for the rest of my career. So right now, I'm pretty sure that I want to do pediatric oncology, that I want to work with kids with cancer. And so that's why I applied to St. Jude, because this is kind of the best place in America to do research in pediatric cancer care. So that's what I do now. And I definitely feel like the meaningful research experience that I've gotten from St. Jude is what helped me get into this MD-PhD program. I have a little bit of a unique situation because my PI is also an MD, and she goes into clinic every week and sees patients. And so what I've been able to do is go into clinic with her and see how she interacts with patients, really learn what it takes to be the kind of doctor that these kids need. And so I've also taken the opportunity to ask really tough questions and to ask her what it's like to be a pediatric oncologist. It's one of those fields of medicine that can be super, super difficult and is difficult a lot of the time. And I want to make sure that if I'm going to dedicate my life to this field, that it's actually what I want to do and I actually know what I'm getting into. And so she's been very honest with me about the hardships that she faces as a pediatric oncologist, but she has also been honest with me about how rewarding and how great it is. And my time at St. Jude has really shown me how much I really want to be in this line of work. I know that 60% of medical students end up in a residency program practicing medicine that's unlike what they wanted to do when they entered medical school. And so I am keeping an open mind to the experiences that I'm going to have in medical school, but I also am so in love with pediatric oncology. I've done a lot of shadowing and obviously a lot of research in this field, and it's what I really love, and it's what I'm pretty sure I'm gonna end up doing. The other things that I've done in my gap years is study for the MCAT, which I'm gonna make a whole other video about my MCAT experience, and fill out my application, which opened in June. And then once your primary applications go out to the schools that you're interested in. By the way, if you guys are interested in me making a video on how to choose medical schools to apply to, I can totally do that. That would be a lot of fun. But I sent out my primary application to the schools that I was interested in. And then if they were interested in me, they sent me a secondary application. And I suggest getting your primary and secondary applications in as soon as possible. A lot of schools do rolling admissions, which means it's kind of a first come, first serve. If you're the first applicant to pass through the desk of the people who are looking at applications, then you're gonna be probably one of the first people to get interviews and to get accepted if that's the path that that medical school wants to take with you. So I suggest getting everything in as early as possible. I feel like that's something that really helped me get into medical school, was I had all of my stuff in very, very early. The next step after completing your secondary application is, if the school likes you, they will send you an invitation to interview. Now, once you get to the interview phase, they already know that you're gonna be successful academically, and they just wanna see your personality and who you are, and wanna make sure that you're gonna have good bedside manner. And I'm also gonna make a whole other video on how to prepare for interviews, how I prepared for interviews. As a little bit of a background, I've had 2 interviews so far. I had 1 MD-PhD interview at Virginia Commonwealth that was successful. And then I had another MD only interview at the medical school in my hometown, Washington State University. And it's a very new school. They don't have an MD-PhD program, but because it was in my hometown, I really wanted to apply. So I'll go into more detail in a different video about how to prepare for interviews, how I prepared for interviews, my big tips and tricks on how to be successful. So that'll be coming soon. The last thing that I've been doing in my gap years is really enjoying not being in school. I love school, and you kind of have to love school in order to be a doctor, since you're going to be learning so much for so long. But I'm really enjoying the free time that I have. I've been able to do things that I wasn't able to do when I was in college. Really take advantage of free time just to relax and get my head in a good spot before I go to school. And I've also learned how to film and edit and start this YouTube channel, which would have been more difficult if I were in school already. Not saying it can't be done, but for me, it was a lot easier to have all this free time to learn how to edit and to learn how to film and to really get this YouTube channel going before I got into school. That's kind of the background of my journey into medicine and my road to an MD-PhD program. If there's any information that you guys think I left out, please let me know in the comments, because I would be happy to make another video that adds that information in. Please like the video if you liked it, and please subscribe if you want to see more videos from me. I post videos about medical school, that's my main purpose, but I also post vlogs. If you're interested in those things, please stick around, hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell so that you get notified when I upload, and thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate you guys being here, and I'll see you next time.